love. Hon, can you make it louder a little bit? Turn it loud. یکمی پیشتر اگه بیایم شاید مردم بیشتر بیاین. گرچه پارکینگ لات ها پر است، تعداد نمیفهم چرا، و در پایین هم جای داریم. یعنی اگر اینجا پر شد پایان هم تقریبا در حدود 400-500 نفر جا میگیره و میشه پایان تشریف ببرین. البته پایان بالا اردو یکی است، کدام تفاوتی ندارد، در صحن مسجد هست، پایین هم و بالا هم کدام بی احترامی به کسی نیست، صرف برای از اینکه جاگزین شوه همه کمی پیشتر، شاید ازدحام پیشتر شوه. و البته امامت آقای ابوبکر مجدی صاحب که اونا سان فرانسیسکو تشریف میارن، البته ما انتظاری از اونا را هم داریم. و تا او وقت که تکبیرات البته توسط برادرها سروده میشن، و همچنان باید یادآوری بدارم که فطر روزه حداقل $10 است یا $15 تعیین گردیده فی نفره در هر فامیل، پر پرسن پر هید کاونت این در فامیلی، دات ایتس مندیتوری فطر آف روزه to be dropped in the box before you perform the Eid prayer. Please do so. It's $10 or $15, but if you put $15, that will be on the safe side. It goes to the masjid's budget. It will be spent on the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I welcome all of you, brothers and sisters. We have a mix of Afghani brothers, Pakistanis, Arabs, what have you, and I welcome all of you, especially our young crowd with beautiful dress, that they are here to celebrate Eid. As you know, Hadith Sharif of Prophet, peace be upon him, we have 2 days of celebration and joy, Eid al-Fitr and Eid al-Adha, that Muslims are recommended to be happy and enjoy these 2 days and celebrate as the jubilant day today. And according to the Sunnah and Hadith of Prophet, peace be upon him, today is after like 30 days fasting and obeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the most important pillar of Islam, or one of the most important pillars of Islam, to fast in the month of Ramadan. I congratulate all of us that we went through this month of piety, going according to Islam and Quran, the month of revelation of Quran. And I congratulate all of us that they went through successfully and finished this month. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept our prayer. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept our fasting. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept our reading of Quran and recitation and joining the group prayers and taraweehs in the mosque. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept our sadaqats, that in this month that we had brothers that they came, or sisters, they came forward and supported this mosque, especially in the month of Ramadan, generously, that they put forward their exertion, their will, their money. And we appreciate and we pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give them the rewards here and hereafter. And especially those that they supported the iftar time, the fully, the 30 days, the iftar time, and they prepared the food for those that they were fasting. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give them all the rewards. The ones that they came, like three brothers, they led the prayer in Taraweeh, three young brothers. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give them all the rewards and blessing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah be pleased with them. Ladies and gentlemen, today we hear here and there in the world we have turbulence, we have bloodshed, we have problems all over the world, especially on the soil of Muslims, whether that's in Middle East or Far East, Afghanistan, Syria, Iraq, or for that matter here in this country, we hear the suicide attacks and killing, mass killings. And Islam doesn't call for killing. Islam doesn't call for harming others. But Prophet, peace be upon him, he said, Wallahi, he would not enter paradise, and he is not a Muslim, if people are not safe or protected from his tongue and his hand, meaning Muslims cannot emotionally hurt others and physically cannot hurt others. And Quran says vividly, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala through Quran, that if you kill one soul, like you killed all the humankind on earth, if you save one soul, you saved all of them. It cannot be more profound and clear and transparent that Muslims cannot harm, cannot kill, cannot violate and hurt emotionally or physically. Those that they are committing those crimes, those they are violating, they are going against Islam, they are going against Quran, they are going against Prophet, peace be upon him, his saying and doing, Sunnah and Hadith. And we Muslims, when we come in interactions with each other, that we say Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu, meaning that peace be unto you and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blessings be unto you, cannot be more clear than this, that we Muslims, that we go according to Quran and Sunnah of Prophet, peace be upon him. Quran itself says you cannot kill a soul, and Prophet says, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala be pleased with him, that he said cannot enter Jannah if people are not protected and safe emotionally and physically. So it's more profound, it cannot be more clear than this. So whatever happened and transpired in the United States or all over the world, Islam doesn't call for killing. Islam doesn't call for emotional and physical hurting. It's individual act of those people. Ladies and gentlemen, coming to the mosque here, this place was 42 years old church, and now it's been like 5 years old masjid, the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, one God has been worshipped, and it's a full-fledged mosque. It turned and remodeled to be a mosque. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give all the rewards to those people that they diligently worked hard and made it possible to be a mosque. And also the executive board of the mosque, from Brother Jamil Khan to Brother Hanif, to Brother Samir, they work so hard, and they are here all the time, 24-hour basis, if they are called on, and they will help the Muslims if they need to be. And also our brother Mahmoud, that is standing here passing the box, Mahmoud, he is always here. He leads 5-time prayers in the mosque, and he gives his time, exertion, expertise. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless him and his family. Can you come a little bit forward, please, because we are short of space. This is Ron Dirasi. Can you come a little bit forward? We have a lot of room here. Yeah. So him and his family is giving his time. imam five times, if you come to the mosque five times, this place is open for group prayers, jamaat. And also, we have brothers that they worked through the years and made this mosque possible. The board that from Jamil to Hanif to Samir to myself, Mr. Mahjoub, Mr. Weiss Sharq, and our other brothers, Mr. Qayyum Gardizi, and there are like a few people that they really worked hard. And I go through the history of this mosque, brother Commandant Sahib Madumar Khan, who was the founder of this place, and he ran the place for almost 15, 16 years. He passed away a few years ago. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive his soul, him and his wife, that they are not with us. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give him the rewards and hereafter for being so diligent and worked so hard to make this mosque possible and open the doors for almost 15, 16 years. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give you all the rewards that you are here and celebrating this beautiful day of Eid al-Fitr. Brothers and sisters, please, I ask you, according to what Quran says, and Prophet, peace be upon him, manifested Quran in his interactions and social life, that to be generous to your Islamic centers where one God is worshipped, that this place is one of the places, if you put your money in the budget of the mosque, it's a perpetual khairat and perpetual rewards for all of us. It's not going to die. It's not for one day or 2 days. As long as we are around and we are worshiping what one God, inshallah, the numbers will increase and multiply, and people will come to Islam and find the new meaning and profound meaning of Islam. Inshallah, Muslims will increase by number, as I remember in the country I lived for past 38 years, I was privy to all this. And the numbers are doubling, and people are coming to Islam. They are embracing Islam, and they learn more Islam. And Islam is the religion of rescuing us from going astray, ourselves, our family, and a religion of prosperity, the religion of peace, the religion of rules, regulations. It's not that to get the label of killing and bloodshedding, that's not Islam. Islam embrace people. Islam really respect others' rights and protecting other people's rights. So that's what we are somehow contributing to have the center going and running. You know, these Islamic centers and places like this are somehow run by donations, by help of all Muslim ummahs. And the congregation like this, like today, that we have like over maybe 1,000 people, and especially the Fitr Sadaqah, which is minimum like $15 to be dropped in the box before we perform the prayer of Eid, it's mandatory. Please do so and put your $15 per person, per family. Like if you're like one person, it's $15. The numbers, you multiply that by 15. So it's mandatory, actually. It's not zakat, sadaqah, or khairat. It's mandatory. Over that, whatever you put in the mosque's box or budget, inshallah, it's going to be applied towards the expenses of this mosque. I strongly, brothers and sisters, recommend to do so. Before I go on, خواهر و برادرای عزیز، ما یک دو نفر از افغانستان از رای بسیار دور تشریف آوردن. البته بالای بایسکل سوار تر و پدر هر دوی از اونا از افغانستان بالای بایسکل دمی راه های صعب العبور اتا به نیویورک خود رساندن در اروپا و از اونجا یقینا در تیارات در نیویورک برای ملل متحد که در اونجا به رئیس مؤسسه ملل متحد خود برسانند و برای ازوا بگویند که در افغانستان بسیار بعد حال از خون ریختنده میشه که ملل متحد بعد اقل یک توجه بداره به حال مردم بیچاره افغانستان. بسیار زحمت کشیدن، از راه های بسیار دور تشریف آوردن و اونا را ما در تلویزیون هم یک ساعت مصاحبه و صحبتی از اونا را پخش کردیم. اونا با همراه ما هستن و یقینا کسایی هستن که صرف برای ای که افغانستان از این مصائب رهایی پیدا کنه و صدای مردم افغانستان با ملل متحد به حیث یک احتجاج اتا برسانه و همی کارم کردن، با ملل متحد خود رساندن و صدای مردم افغانستان به اونجا آوردن. و شما میدانین که با اسکیل سواری او هم با صدها کیلومتر یا مایل آمدن و یا قربانی بلایواز برای مردم افغانستان دادن. اینا به اینجا تشریف آوردن، دکتر صاحب نادرشاه و پسرکشان داود خان هر دویشان یعنی در اینجا با ما هستن و اینا یقینا دوستای محترم یعنی جیب خالی آمدن. تو از امون وارلاردای افغانستان از یک محلی که در اونجا با پول و پیسه آمده باشن، اینا با یک پیام آمدن. اینا برای ازی آمدن که در افغانستان صلح و سلام حاکم شوه و امروز با ما هستن. یکیشان توهیس، اگر شما $10 $20 هر قدری که میتانین برای برگشت از اینا کمک میشه و برای افغانستان بزرگ اینا آمدن تشریف آوردن، پسر و پدر. و ما خود ما هم یک چیزی که اگر در وسط ما پور از دونیت میکنم برای امی کاز برای افغانستان، خصوصا که اینا زحمت کشیدن هم برای برادر ما و هم حیثیت یک تقدیر داره و هم ای که یک کمک میشه در راه صلح. که هر یکی ما میگم فکر ما نارام است، در افغانستان جنگ است، صلح نیست، و امی مردم یعنی در راه صلح قدم گذاشتن. نادر خان راست دلت دوار راست رضا دو جان ترست دیگه اینا برادر ما هستن، از اونجا تشریف آوردن و پسرشان در سی این این و دیگه رسانه ها و تلویزیون هم اینا را پخش شد. دیگه اگر لطف شوا خوب شد خوب میشه اینا را دمی عید مبارکی دیدین، یک چیز مخفی $50 $100 $10 کرای رای پس اینا تشریف میبرن و زندگی دارن در اینجا مثل ما وری آرام، پس در اون محل جنگ و مصائب افغانستان داخل میشن. دیگه لطفا اگر چی شد امیر مهربانی کنین. نادر خان از خوبه،
ایدم وطن تبریک میگم،
ایدم تبریک میگم. تو داریم رو
ما باش با یک سوال ما میکردم.
او یک سوال دارم.
خود شروع میکنم، شال بشر کلانم نگی بیادر خود. خدا عوض هر کسی که میتانه، یعنی به نظر ما به عقیده ما یعنی در این محل وقت داخل میشین یک چار قران برای از اونا برای مسجد کمک میشه، دونیت میشه. For those people that they didn't understand maybe Farsi, we had these two brothers that they came from Afghanistan bicycling from Afghanistan like thousands miles away. They came all the way to New York to bring the message of peace and bring it to the attention of the United Nations, and they met with the head of the United Nations, Ban Ki-moon, and they are going back to Afghanistan, and we wanted to donate a few dollars that they may probably incurred expenses. I think we should, from $1 to whatever we can to help them. It will be especially Islam is the religion of peace, and they came to bring the message of peace to the United Nations. But anyhow, we are waiting, brothers and sisters, for our Imam, Brother Mujaddidi, to come. He's coming all the way from Northern California, from the Bay Area. I hope he's not gotten stuck in somewhere on the freeway, and will be with us. Of course, he speaks all three languages, Pashto, Dari, and English. His khutbah would be mostly in English. And I just wanted to fill the gap and kill time that you don't get bored. And I can do so much, but other than that, I don't know what to say. And we will do more takbirat. And inshallah, it's such a beautiful, beautiful occasion today. I see we are all happy, inshallah, and especially the month of Ramadan, that the month of cleaning our mind, our hearts from the animosity, vengeance, jealousy, name it, what have you, that to clean, you know, it's a, I would call them the weeding out of our mind's garden and get rid of all the thorns, all the vegetation that doesn't bring any fruit to us, and be a clean and good Muslims than our interactions, especially portraying Islam and calling ourselves as a ambassador of Islam in the non-Islamic country, would be better to really be Muslim, to represent Islam the way it should be, and follow the footpath of Prophet, peace be upon him. And inshallah we'll do. But of course, you see, we all have our mental, physical problems and miseries. The world is full of miseries. I think, you know, just the more we advance in technology and science, the more we are worried, the more we rush, the more we accelerate. And that brings a lot of worries, a lot of problems, a lot of agonies. So I hope we clean that, and Islam has the prescription for all of that. And if we really go to the depth of the meaning of Quran and Sunnah of Prophet, peace be upon him. But anyhow, yeah, we have finally our Imam, Brother Abu Bakr Mujaddidi, that he takes his time coming all the way from the Bay Area, which is almost like 400 or 500 miles. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give him all the rewards, blessing to him and his family, that he is joining us for past 2-3 Eids. And he speaks in both languages, of course, like Dari and maybe Pashto and English. Of course, he would have a good khutbah today for us. And I welcome him and I thank him. And I pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who gives his time and exertion and diligently from his heart working and giving sadaqah, whatever they have their disposal in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, like Brother Abu Bakr Mujaddidi is doing. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless him and his family. And I thank him, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept his prayer. And I will give him the mic to Brother Abu Bakr, and inshallah he will lead the prayer. And
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Alhamdulillah, it's I was actually very humbled by the few words that Janaba Omar Khattab said just stated, but I'm actually humbled myself to be here in the presence of our Muslim brothers and sisters in such an auspicious event and such a blessed day. Celebrating such a blessed event. And alhamdulillah, I'm actually proud of every single one of you here that you've established a Islamic center in a masjid in Southern California, alhamdulillah. And this is, inshallah, may Allah make it a place of hidayah, a place of guidance, a source of love, a source of compassion, a source of unity, and a source of brotherhood and sisterhood amongst the community. And especially our brothers and sisters from Afghanistan who have seen so much troubles throughout the years and are still witnessing it. But alhamdulillah, at least we have a place to come and console our hearts and console our minds. So I'm proud of every single one of you, especially Janab Khattab Sahib, who has had the audacity and the leadership, and other brothers and sisters who've had the leadership to establish such a beautiful and such a magnanimous masjid and Islamic center. So I'm going to give a quick overview of the prayer, because we pray it only twice a year. So many of us who know the prayer, we may even forget. And so a quick overview in English, and I'll give one in Dari as well. So you make niyyah. You make niyyah that I make niyyah to pray two rakats of Eid al-Fitr prayer, which is wajib upon me. That is wajib. It's wajib upon me with the takbirat. It's six takbirat that's going to take place. Three in the first rakat, three in the last rakat. And then we say, of course, Ru'ud al-Maqabla, Qabla Iman Jad Khani Kabir Sharifa, Khalasallah Ta'ala, Allahu Akbar. And then you go and you just based on your mazhab, place your hands where you're supposed to. And of course, Imam Abu Hanifa, many of us are in the Hanafi mazhab. You place it right under the navel as far as the men go. And you recite Subhanaka Allahumma. Subhanaka Allahumma wa bihamdika wa tabaraka ismika wa ta'ala jaddaka wa la ilaha ghairuk. So you recite that. And after you recite that, I will be saying Allahu Akbar. So then you raise your hands to your ears, and then you let it go. And then I'll say Allahu Akbar for the second time, and then you raise your hands again, and then you allow it to sit beside you. And then I'm gonna say Allahu Akbar for the third time, and then that's the third takbir, and then you guys are going to close your hands, clasp your hands, and I will be reciting Surah Fatiha and another surah. And then we go to Ruku and Sujood, and after we get back from Sujood, I will be reciting Surah Fatiha and another surah, and then there's going to be three takbirat again. Allahu Akbar, and you keep your arms beside you, and then Allahu Akbar, you keep your arms beside you, Allahu Akbar, you keep your arms beside you, and then on the fourth Allahu Akbar, you go to Ruku, and we complete the prayer, and then we will be giving a khutbah, which is part of the Eid prayer. Inshallah, bafarsyam zikr kunim ya hamagi famidan, inshallah. Bafarsyam zikr kunim. Inshallah, namaz Eid ra hamagi, inshallah, agah hasan hamagi me faman. Lakin chunun ke sal do dafa khanda me shava, az baz imkan dara ke faramush shava. دیگه اول نیت میکنین که نیت کردم ادا سازم دو رکعت نماز عید سعید فطر که بالا سر ما واجب هست با تکبیراتش رو آدم به قبله قبله من جهد خانه کعبه شریفه خالص الله تعالی الله اکبر وقتی که الله اکبر میگن شما سبحانک اللهم میخوانین وقتی که سبحانک اللهم خواندین باز امام تکبیر میگه شما دستایتون را پیش گوشتون میگیرین و باز در بغلتان آویزان میکنین و باز دفعه دوم تکبیر گفته میشه و دستار باز مثل نیت ولی بلند میکنین باز در بغل خود آویزان میکنین باز تکبیرات سیوم که میشه دستار بلند میکنین باز دستار و نمطور که به قیام استاد میشوین به مو شکل استاد میشوین و باز سوره فاتحه رو یک سوره دیگر که من انشاءالله ذکر کردم باز به مو شکل به رکوع میرین و نمطور به سجود میرین و باز از سجده که پس استاد شوین باز سوره فاتحه را خوانده میشه باز یک سوره دیگر باز سه تکبیر گفته میشه باز اونم تو سه تکبیر دستار بلند میکنین مثل نیاتوری و آویزان میکنین و در تکبیر چهارم به رکوع میره و انشاءالله باز اونم تو سجود و اینها بعد از اتحیات نماز تکمیل میشه و بعدا خطبه که سنت و هم واجب هست در ماه عید اضحی و عید سعید فطر باز بعد از اون انشاءالله همگی آزاد هستن و با یک دیگه عید مبارکی میکنن انشاءالله
الله اکبر الله اكبر الله اكبر الله اكبر
الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. ألم نشرح لك صدرك ووضعنا عنك وزرك الذي أنقض ظهرك ورفعنا لك ذكرك فإنما الأسر يسرا إنما الأسر يسرا فإذا فرغت فانسب وإلى ربك فارغب. الله أكبر. سمي الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين. إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. إنا أنزلناه في ليلة القدر وما أدراك ما ليلة القدر. ليلة القدر خير من ألف شهر. تنزل الملائكة والروح فيها بإذن ربهم من كل أمر. سلام هي حتى مطلع الفجر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. سمي الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. استغفر الله. استغفر الله. السلام عليكم. أمير العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا الشافعي النبي أحمد السليم قاتم النبيين سيد المرسلين أشرف الأنبياء والآله وصحبه أجمعين اللهم اهدنا في من هديت وعافنا في من عافيت وتولنا في من توليت وباركنا في ما آتيت وقنا الشر ما قضيت فإن تقضي ولا يقضى عليك تبارك ربنا وتعاليت نستغفرك ونتوب عليك اللهم تقبل قيامنا يا أرحم الراحمين اللهم تقبل ركوعنا يا أرحم الراحمين اللهم تقبل سجودنا يا أرحم الراحمين اللهم تقبل صلاتنا يا أرحم الراحمين اللهم تقبل صيامنا في صيام الشهر رمضان يا أرحم الراحمين اللهم اغفرنا وارحمنا يا أرحم الراحمين اللهم اغفرنا وارحمنا ولوالدينا ولوالدي والدنا وأستاذنا والمشايخنا وصغيرنا وكبيرنا وشهادنا وغيب وجميع المؤمنين والمسلمين والمسلمات برحمتك يا عزيز يا غفار يا كريم يا ستار يا أرحم الراحمين ربنا لا تؤاخذنا إن نسينا وأخطأنا ربنا ولا تحمل علينا إثما كما حملته على الذين من قبلنا ربنا ولا تحملنا ما لا طاقة لنا به واعف عنا واغفر لنا وارحمنا واعف عنا واغفر لنا وارحمنا واعف عنا واغفر لنا وارحمنا أنت مولانا فانصرنا على القوم الكافرين يا أرحم الراحمين سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين الحمد لله رب العالمين. أما بعد فقال الله عز وجل في كتاب المجيد فرقان حميد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم يا أيها الذين آمنوا كتب عليكم الصيام كما كتب على الذين من قبلكم لعلكم تتقون صدق الله المولانا العظيم. برادرای محترم خواهرای گرامی السلام علیکم و رحمت الله و برکاته. سبحان الله الحمدلله یک واقعا جای یک نعمت حق سبحان الله و تعالی است و جای شکر است که دوباره ما شما امروز جمع شدیم بعد از یک ماه مبارک، یک ماه پر از رحمت، ماه پر از مغفرت. خداوند عبادات و اطاعت همه ما شما را به دربار خود در راه خود قبول بفرمایه ان شاء الله. و سبحان الله ایمان ماه مبارک رمضان همیشه در تاریخ جهان با عزت قرار داشته بود. هر کتاب آسمانی که بوده به ماه مبارک رمضان نازل شده بوده. اگر زبور بود که به سیدنا داود علیه السلام نازل شده بود، اگر تورات بود به سیدنا حضرت موسی علیه السلام نازل شده بود، اگر انجیل بود که به سیدنا حضرت عیسی علیه السلام نازل شده بود، و قرآن الحمدلله همگی ما آگاه هستیم که در این ماه مبارک رمضان به تمام کائنات به همگی و به رسول اکرم صلی الله علیه و سلم نازل شده بوده. و یعنی که این ما را همیشه حق سبحان الله تعالی پیششان یک ایما عزت داشته، همیشه زیر عزت قرار داشته. و روزه گرفتن انمتا که به ما شما واجب فرض است، بر امتهای سابق هم واجب بوده. عیسویان هم روزه می گرفتن، یهودا هم روزه می گرفتن. یعنی این دو چیز را از محبت که حق سبحان الله تعالی بر امت رسول الله صلی الله علیه و سلم داشتن، از محبت و شفقت که برای هر فرد مسلمان و مسلمه حق سبحان الله تعالی داشت، این دو را با هم پیوست کرد. روزه را که همیشه به حساب یک از عبادات بسیار عزیز بود پیش حق سبحان الله تعالی که به دیگر امت هم داده بود، او را با این ماه مبارک رمضان، با این ماه مبارک که تمام کتابای آسمانی در این وقت ذکر شد، ایره همیشه با هم پیوست کرد و با ما و شما مثل یک تحفه واره که از این ما استفاده کنیم و از این ما از مرحمتش، از لطف و کرم الهی ما آگاه شویم و خداوند جل شأنه گناهای ما را و را کلش خداوند انشاءالله که وعده است، وعده رسول اکرم صلی الله علیه و سلم است. حق سبحان الله تعالی گفته که مؤمن و مسلمانه که واقعا این ماه مبارکه صحیح تر کنه، حق سبحانه وتعالی تمام گناهایش را مغفرت میکنه، تمام گناهایش را میبخشه. و ما انشاءالله که به می امید هستیم که حق سبحانه وتعالی عبادت و اطاعت همه ما شما را قبول بفرمایه انشاءالله و خداوند ما را زیر مغفرت خود، زیر محبت خود همیشه قرار داشته باشه. This is one of the holiest months in the calendar of the Islam. This is the most holiest month in the calendar of Islam. In actuality, like I mentioned in Dari, this month has been always in honor and esteem even before Islam came. Even the, before the coming of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Allah held this month in esteem and honor and respect. How? He had revealed every single book to every single prophet in the month of Ramadan. If it was Zubur, if it was Injil, if it was the Torah, if it was the Quran that was given to Hazrat Isa, Musa, Dawood alayhi salatu wasalam, and Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasalam, it was given in this month. And the, like I said in the Quran, كُتِبَ عَلَيْكُمَ السِّيَامُ كَمَا كُتِبَ عَلَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلَكُمْ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. Oh, oh, you believe, fasting is prescribed to you as it was prescribed to those before you. So fasting was prescribed to those before us, meaning the other ummahs. And Allah, because of the love He has for every single one of you, and the compassion Allah has for every single one of you, for the ummah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, He has brought together the month that He has held in honor, and the worship that He's always loved, which is fasting, together for us to cleanse our hearts, to purify our nafs, to purify our soul, and what? Tattaqoon, to become God conscious. What does that mean? That means that we have to become aware, Jazakallah Khair, become aware of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in every single moment. Islam, Ramadan brings a stop to daily activities. Something that's halal for us. Something that we can have is water, food, drink. It becomes haram for us during this, while the sun is up, during the time of Ramadan. Why? Because even scientists today, medical doctors today say that one of the biggest things a person is unable to control is his stomach, is the food that he takes. Look what's happening today in this country, in the Western world. Obesity is the number one cause of death, okay? Coronary disease, strokes, heart attacks, everything is linked to obesity. Of course, heredity can be also a factor, but mainly obesity. Why? Because our nafs, we can't control what we have. But when you're able to control the thing that you want the most, you become empowered. You empower yourself. Ramadan is for here to become powerful over your nafs, to become powerful over your ego. People are paying tens of thousands of dollars to Tony Robbins and life coaches so they could get self-esteem. Ramadan is here for you to get self-esteem. To know that, no, you're above your nafs. You're above what you want in life. And not imagine this, that the things that are halal for you becomes haram. And then imagine the things that are haram in every day. It's haram in Ramadan. That allows you to stay away from everything else, from backbiting, from slander, from ghaibah, from doing wrong to somebody, cursing somebody, even controlling your anger. Controlling other desires you have. This actually strengthens you, strengthens your spirit. This is the essence of the month of Ramadan, alhamdulillah. And now, when I was in school, when we first started school, my teacher told the whole class, he said, today, you guys are all starting with an A. Every single one of you have an A grade today, is what my teacher said. He said, now it's up to you. That how are you going to keep this grade? Are you going to keep the A, or are you going to allow it to drop? So today, every single one of you have an A in your Iman. You have an A in your Islam. You have an A in your Taqwa, because Allah gave you the Rahmah to cleanse your heart, to cleanse your nafs. Now, it's up to you. The Ramadan is over. Ramadan is over, but it's up to you to keep that momentum, the spirit of Ramadan, alive in your hearts, alive in your families, alive in your communities. Because the God of Ramadan, who we adhere to everything He said, alhamdulillah, and how much compassion we felt in our lives, in our hearts, that God of Ramadan is the same God of Shawwal. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not change. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not change. The months change. Ramadan is gone. May Allah grant us all the rahmah and compassion of Ramadan. But the Lord, the Rabb of Ramadan, is the Rabb of Shawwal, is your Rabb. He stays. So we must still adhere to the commandments of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we must still hold dear to the commandments of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And may Allah accept every single one of our fasting, every single one of our worship, and every single one of our sincere devotion to Allah and continue the momentum and the spirit of Ramadan alive in our hearts and our lives. Another thing that I want to talk about, these are stuff that we will hear everywhere. We in the Muslim Ummah are living in a very crucial time. You don't need a political pundit or somebody who's an analysis of politics and sociology or what have you to tell you that we're in a crisis. Muslims and Islam is in a crisis in the world and in America. And we must wake up from our slumber. We must wake up from our daily activities and become aware. Today, this year is an election year. This year is a year that we have one of the most contested elections in this country. And guess who's in the forefront? Muslims. Muslims are on the forefront of this election. Today you have a bigot. You have somebody who is spreading hateful rhetoric against Muslims. Why? To achieve some political success. To blame, scapegoat every problem that America has on a few people. The social injustice, the economic injustice that big business has done, they're trying to blame it on America, just like Hitler blamed it on the Jews. Now, it is your responsibility as Muslims to become aware that people are using your name. People are using the name of Ahmed, Muhammad, Abu Bakr, Omar, Osman, Ali. These are the names that are being used for their political agendas. We must become awake. There's billions of dollars right now while we're sleeping, while we're away, there's billions of dollars being spent against our religion, against our faith. But we need to wake up as a people and understand what our faith is. Understand what the message of Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam is. And what is our responsibility here in America? You guys have a responsibility in America. You have a responsibility for these children that you must become active in social society. Become aware of what's happening around you. We need a lobby group in Washington to lobby for Muslims. To lobby for our countries, to lobby for Afghanistan, to lobby for Pakistan, to lobby for Palestine, to lobby for Muslim countries. We need to wake up. This is the time to wake up. Every time they say something bad about Muslims, the ratings of Donald Trump rises. Why? Because we have taken our face out of society. Psychologists say that the biggest fear a person has, not every person, but the majority of people, arachnophobia. Who knows arachnophobia? Fear of spiders. And, excuse me. Spiders, 95% is harmless. 5% tarantulas and black widows and stuff are harmful. Snakes, 95% of snakes are harmful. 5% like garden snakes or what have you, are harmless. But people fear spiders more than they fear snakes. So psychologists were wondering, why are people fearing something harmless more than something harmful? Why? Because you can't put a face. You can't put a face on a spider. A snake, you see the eyes. You see the nose. You see the mouth. So there is a face you put on it. But a spider, if you can't put a face on it, it's our nature, the fitrat insanas. And what's happening in America today, they're trying to take the face out of Islam. They're trying to take the face of humanity out of Islam. The face of compassion out of Islam. The face of love out of Islam. The face of family out of Islam. So people can feel you. What we need to do is we need to put a face on our religion. We need to put a face on our faith. We need to put a face that, alhamdulillah, Muslims are here to salvage this country. Muslims are here to protect their neighbors. Muslims are here to spread good, to spread charity amongst our people. Muslims are here to uplift the community from what is wrong to what is right. We are doctors, we are engineers, we are professionals, we're in the IT industry, we are developing apps. We need to let people know that we are here as Muslims, as Afghans, as Pakistanis, of people from every single ethnicity group that makes up Muslims, we need to go out there and bring our face, show our face. This is who we are. We are a people who love our families. You need to go and talk to your neighbors. Invite your neighbors over. Invite your Christian and invite your Jewish neighbors over. Let them know who you are. Let them know what your religion is, what your faith is. You have a responsibility in this country. Don't just keep Islam in one small community. No. Islam is not just made for us. Islam is made for all mankind. And that's what we need to do. This is a responsibility. Why is Donald Trump rising? And because we have been sleeping. We have been sleeping. 20,000, 30,000 people go to his rallies. Why? Because they hear Islam and they just want to point a finger and blame all the problems on Islam and Muslims. Do we have problems in our community? Yes. I agree with that. We have a problem in our community. And that problem has to be addressed. There are people in our community that is misusing the name of Islam. That is misusing the name. Look what happened. Look what happened. 2 days ago, what happened? The resting place of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The home of Rasulullah. The masjid of Rasulullah. The place that he left because of the kuffar, because of the persecution, and he found security. Today in Ramadan, he had no security in his own masjid. This is our doing. We must wake up to this. This stuff that's happening, Rasulullah 1400 years ago predicted this. In Sahih Hadith, he said, from my ummah, از امت ما اشخاص میخیزه که اونها آیت های قرآن رو میخواین بگوین لیکن از گذونشون پایان نمیره و سینایشون جای نداره و قلبشون جای نداره نیتشون نداره اینا تنها آیت های قرآن رو از خاطر مسائل سیاسی و اجتماعی خود استفاده میکنن این رسول اکرم صلی الله علیه وسلم گفته 1400 سال پیش و میگن که اینها غیر قتل و قتال رو جهان پیش میکنن این خود رسول اکرم گفته صلی الله علیه و سلم که جوانها رو من میخواییم بگویم که میگم که اینا به لباسهای اسلام داخل میشون و شما رو بازی میتن بازی نخورین بفهمین که دین شما دین حق است دین محبت است دین رحمت است او دینی نیست که یک انسان رو بیگناه را از بین ببره ای او دین هست که حفاظت انسان و کائنات رو میکنه حفاظت یک حیوان که در سرک است این دین حفاظت از رو میکنه یونو دین است خود رسول اکرم گفته علامای از اینا رو گفتن گفتن جوان ها جوان می باشن اکثرشون جوان می باشه شما اکثر از اینا رو ببینید کلش جوان است میگن اینها بسیار زود سر مغزشون یک گپ از سخن سرشون دفتن تاثیر میکنه یعنی زود برین واش میشن اینها رو زود به حساب به نظر دیگه گرفته میشه اینها را کلش رسول اکرم صلی الله علیه و سلم گفتن که از این مردم احتیاط کنین و هدفشون چیست؟ این حدیث گفته من خونم میگم هدفشون ایست که بیت الله را بزنن و این امروز تمام که صدقت یا رسول الله صلی الله علیه و سلم ما شما درست پیش دیدیم که اینها به کدام را روان بودن که اینها جایی که رسول اکرم خوابیده جایی که رحمت العالمین خوابیده جایی که رسول محمد رسول الله صلی الله علیه و سلم آرامی پیدا کرد جایی که بر از او خانه خود انصار واس کرد که گفتن که از او مشکلات که تو در مکه میبینی در اینجا آرامی هست سکونت است و امروز او سکونت رسول اکرم صلی الله علیه و سلم در مدینه نمیبینه چی حالت است با لباس اسلامی و با کلمه محمدی کار میکنن نعوذ بالله من ذلک همه این مسئله نیست که ابو بکر برای شما گفته رسول اکرم براتون میگه که احتیاط کنین I'm telling the youth be careful of some of the stuff you hear be careful don't fall in the trap there's traps laid out in these traps there's people behind it لباس اسلام نهن اما در پشتشان یهود نصارا استاد است در پشتشان استخبارات های بگانه استاد است استخبارات های بگانه است که اونها را تشویق میکنه راهنمایی میکنه اونها را بیراه میکنه اونها را پول میده که اینا این کارا رو بکنن که یک صدمه خود اینا خواسته به دین مقدس اسلام برسه و نمیرسه انشالله و نرسیده انشالله. همه ما و شما احتیاط کنیم، متوجه باشیم از این چیزا. این کل از این مسائل در حدیث آمده. And I want to leave you with this, that I want to see every single one of you, no, come November, go to the ballots. Make sure you vote. I am not here to represent anybody. I'm here to represent you, to tell you that you have a responsibility in front of Allah. You have a responsibility for these children to make a stand, to become aware of what's happening. What's happening under your name, and what's happening under the flag of Islam, and what's happening under the flag of America. You are all under the flag of America today. You have to know what's happening in this country, and you have a responsibility, and may Allah give us tawfiq to adhere to that responsibility. Astaghfirullah min alladhi la ilaha illa huwa al-hayyul qayyum wa tub alayh. Alhamdulillah, nahmadu wa nasta'inu wa nastaghfiru wa na'udhu billahi min shururi anfusina min sayyiati a'malina man yahdihillahu fala mudilla lahu wa man yudlil fala hadiya lahu wa nashhadu an la ilaha illallah wahdahu la sharika lahu wa nashhadu anna sayyidina Muhammadan 'abduhu wa rasuluhu kadhalika salli wa sallim ala jami'il anbiya'i wal mursalin ala sahabati bitaqiq amir al-mu'minin sayyidina Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiyallahu ta'ala anhu wa ala amir al-mu'minin sayyidina Umar ibn al-Khattab radiyallahu ta'ala anhu والعمير المؤمنين سيدنا عثمان ابن عفان رضي الله تعالى عنهم والعمير المؤمنين سيدنا علي ابن أبي طالب رضي الله تعالى عنهم وإمامين الشهيدين حضرت حمزة وسيدنا حسين وسيدنا حسن رضي الله عنهم عباد الله رحمك الله إن الله يأمر بالعدل وإيتاء ذي القربى وإنهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والباغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون آمين رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين خاتم النبيين سيدنا المرسلين أشرف الأنبياء والعلي وصحابي أجمعين ربنا لا تؤاخذنا إن نسينا وأخطأنا ربنا ولا تحمل علينا إصرا كما حملته على الذين من قبلنا ربنا ولا تحملنا ما لا طاقة لنا به وعفونا واغفرنا وارحمنا أنت مولانا فارسلنا على القوم الكافرين وقوم المشركين وقوم المنافقين يا أرحم الراحمين O Allah accept our prayers يا الله O Allah, accept our fasting, Ya Allah. O Allah, accept our fasting for your favor and for your love, Ya Allah. O Allah, forgive us of our sins, Ya Allah. Forgive the sins that we have committed intentionally. Forgive the sins that we have committed unintentionally, Ya Allah. O Allah, have us under your compassion. Have us under your love, Ya Allah. O Allah, give us sincere love for each other, Ya Allah. Give us sincere brotherhood with each other, Ya Allah. Give us sincere sisterhood amongst each other, Ya Allah. O Allah, grant Jannah to the parents of those who have passed. Forgive our parents, Ya Allah. O Allah, those of us who have our parents, allow us to be kind to them and always have their shadow, guiding shadow above us, Ya Allah. O Allah, protect our children, Ya Allah. O Allah, protect our children from all calamities, from the calamities that are physically upon them and from the calamities that can be a spiritual calamity upon them, Ya Allah. O Allah, give us tazkiyah and tasfiyah of our nafs, Ya Allah. Cleanse our hearts, Ya Allah. Purify our souls and nafs, Ya Allah. O Allah, have the spirit of Ramadan always above us, Ya Allah. O Allah, you hear in every language, Ya Allah. You hear in every language, and we are calling you upon the language that many of us know, Ya Allah. O Allah, forgive us of our sins, Ya Allah. O Allah, have us under your compassion, Ya Allah. Rabbana amanna faktubna ma'a shahideen. Inna Allah malaikatuhu yasalluna ala nabi. يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على سيدنا ونبينا ومولانا محمد المبارك وسلم عليه سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون والسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين إذا همش مبارك أختار مبارك شهر طولته إن شاء الله بير منام
شاف تنوي خالد مبارك وشاري مبارك دوستان عزیز السلام علیکم. ما
در خطاب خطاب از نمبر 1 ریمبر دات
نو دونت تراست هیم دونت بیلیو. دوستان عزیز در صحن حویلی در پارکینگ مسجد سید جمال الدین قرار داریم و دوستای کثیر اینجا جمع شدن. دا اکا دل تراغله اکا څنګه اختر دی مبارک سه
نور ده
ایتا لور ده او ډیر الله دا خو ډیر اکا لور دی د نام خدای سه کوله لور لري ته خو که
کار کی آغه وګور خبر پامیدګر را لته دي.
دا جواب سم ته قربان سم ډیرم.
زما سره د ملاغه نه پر سره و میرسوخان مې دی، حکیم خان مې زابط و، د لوګر و، د زاغه ځای و، نو ډیر څه وزه ته زما سره کوه.
شکر شکر اختر مبارکی دی ووایه خلکو ته دلته.
بس خدای دې د ټولو د اختر مبارک شي، داخل اجان و قاضیان و نماز و روزه طاعت تن قبول.
تا قربان سم ډیر مننه. ته غواړې چې وایې د پلار د خبرې وکړې، ته نه غواړې اختر نه وایې چې ته اختر
مبارک
راځي دلته. Do you want to say some a few words to the Afghan community on TV? Say
Eid Mubarak. I'm on TV.
Yeah, you are.
I'm so sorry. Eid Mubarak to all the Afghans.
You're an Afghan, aren't you?
Yes, I am.
Why didn't you say in Farsi or Pashto? What language do you speak?
I speak Farsi.
Why didn't you say it in Farsi?
Dari.
Dari.
Miss Sharmom.
It goes all over the world.
It's all over the world? Okay.
Eid Mubarak.
Eid. Salam, mardumoy Afghan. Misharum. Namaz va roza qabul. Eid Mubarak.
Afrin, afrin. Bishar Allah. Bishar name khuda jurat dari shukr. I'm proud of you. Ya bayin inja chikunin. You want to say a few words? Teşekkür ederim. ما یک چند نفر کار دارم که گپ بزنه در تلویزیون. سلام
علیکم. نکنید که مدرک افزن زلان خوب نیست. مدرک افزن خوب نیستم با خدا.
بیرین شما خوب
نیست. نکنید با خدا.
عیدتان مبارک.
عید شما مبارک.
روزه و نمازتان قبول.
تشکر زنده باشین. تشکر زنده باشین. افغانان
خدا میز مبارکی و پیام و اینا دارد.
بله، به کل افغانای ما، مسلمانای ما عید از تای دل برتان تبریک میگویم. دیگه خود سلامتی، خوشبختی، روزه و نمازان قبول باشه.
تشکر. سلام علیکم. خوب هستی؟ خیر خیر.
روزه و نماز قبول شد.
خوب بود، رمضان بخیر بود.
بسیار خوب.
اینجا خود زیاد نفر زیاد آمده بود.
آمده بسیار بسیار جمع جوش شد.
خدا هزار نفر زیادتر بیشتر تقریبا 2000 تقریبا هزار.
عین انا تو افغانستان.
بله بله.
این فراموش شد.
بله بله.
خیلی خوشی.
آفرین.
تشکر.
آقا سید شاخ.
ما احترام خود به تمام افغانای سر در سر تا سر دنیا کسن میرسونم. هیچ شما شب شما عید روز شما برات باشه. یا خواهش دیگه دارم از برادرای افغان خود همین پیسای زکات تن افغانستان را کنین به بیوه و یتیم افغانستان. خداوند هر جا که باشه خوش آرام باشین. اتفاق اتحاد داشته باشین یا اولادایتان که دیش کمک کنین درس بخونین یا اولادایتان قرآن از ایشان یاد بتین. اولادایتان رای دین رای محبت قرآن در راهنماییش کنین که شان کار کنین زحمت بکشین. سلام علیکم. احترام دارم.
سردار صاحب سلام
علیکم.
شما بیانی اگه داشته باشین برای افغان‌ها سراسری
این جانب محمد عارف تخلص فامیلیم ذکریا ما عید سعید به تمام ملت مسلمان افغانستان و به تمام مسلمان های جهان تبریک بگم و از خداوند صحت و سلامتیشان هم میخوایم، امنیت آرامی را در افغانستان و تمام ممالک عربی میخوایم، خداوند همه را امنیت و آرامی را بیاره، عاملینش به جزای اعمالش برسانه و کسی که اینا را سپورت هم میکنه، دایش و طالب اینا را خداوند اونا را به جزای اعمالش برسانه و برکت از این روز به عید مبارک داره خداوند. او منتقم حقیقی است انشاءالله که انتقام از این جنایتکارا میگیره. دیگه من دیگه چیز گفتنی ندارم. همه ملت مسلمان افغانستان و سراسر اسلام جان به خدا یگانه میسپارم، خداوند سپورتشان کنه، حفظشان کنه و جمله مهاجرینی که از ممالک خود آمدن که بخواهند به اروپا بیاین و اینا در بدر در دشت و بیابان مانده، خداوند اینا را به جای جایشان برسانه، صاحب خانه و جای زندگی آرام هم که ما را داده اینا را هم بهتر.
آفرین سردار صاحب، بسیار گپای خوب زدید. السلام علیکم. سلام.
امیدوارم روز عید بسیار خوبه داشته باشین. عیدتان تبریک باشه و روزه و نمازتان قبول. و من به اندازه خوش هستم که بین افغانای ما و شما امروز روز عید تجلیل میکنیم. امیدوارم کلگی خوش و صحت و سلامت باشه.
تشکر. تشکر و خیر ببینیم. مهربانی. و علیکم سلام.
سلام و احترامات. اولتر از همه به آقای خطاب صاحب، بسیار لطف و مهربانیشان است. همیشه همکاری کردن از برکت از زمین است که امروز هم افغان ها اینجا آمدن عید تجلیل میکنن. دیگه عید به همه دوست ها تبریک میگم. خداوند یک عید خوش نصیب کل ما شما بکنه و همه دوستایی که در افغانستان هستن. از آقای خطاب صاحب یک دنیا تشکر.
تشکر از شما، بسیار لطف کردید. خب وارد خبری بود که
عید سعید فطر برای تمام ملت غیور افغان تبریک گفته است با امید صلح و آرامی در وطن عزیز ما. یک جهان سپاس آقای خطاب.
تشکر. دوستان عزیز، عید سعید فطر مبارک باشه با همه سراسری طولو تا تبریک و تهنیت وایم. خدایم آرام لره. دلتا تقریبا نه نوی افغانانو پتی جماعت کنن او بیا یو پسلو که شاید نور خلقمو. نو زه ډیر خوشاله سوم افغانان یو بل سره روغبړ یو که ویلی دل په دغه ورځو کې سره برابرېږي. دغه سنت د موږ د پیغمبر صلی الله علیه وسلم چې په دغه دوه ورځو کې باید تاسو خوشاله اوسئ، ښادي وکړئ. نو دا سنت پر ځای سو. خدای دې تاسو هر یو آباد لري. او له آقای ملکیار صاحب که بسیار زحمت کشیدن، کمره بسیار پروفیشنل و یقینا د می زمره بعضی دوستایی که ما میشناسم اینا سابقه دار هم هستن و پروفیشنل تر هم هستن و رفیق تر هم هستن و شریف تر. بسیار تشکر آقای ملکیار، همه را به خداوند لایزال می سپاریم. تشکر.
سلام علیکم، نامه فرناز سلطانی است. عید برتان و کل مسلمان ها دور دنیا تبریک میگم. عید خوش خوش به کلگی آرزو میکنم.
السلام علیکم فری جان گل، تشکر از اینکه زحمت کشیدی و تشریف آوردی و زحمت ها را خداوند تعالی و علای کمکت کنه. عید سعید فطر برای جمعی خلق المؤمنین و المسلمان، مخصوصا به فامیلای افغانستان که وطن عزیز ماست، برشان تبریک میگم. و برای فامیلای متقابل، فامیل کل فامیلایی که اینجا آمدن، کسایی که زحمت کشیدن، یک جهان تشکر که ما را وقت دادین که با شما صحبت کردیم. تشکر خیلی جان.
عید مبارک.
روزه و نماز قبول. روزه و نماز قبول. روزه و نماز قبول.
روزه و نماز قبول.
I'm gonna go to the hospital. سلام سلام، چطور هستی؟